Everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is poetry reading episode. Today I'm going to read to you some of the poems of Brian Patten in his book Juggling with Gerbil. The Wet Goldfish. "I'm wet," said the goldfish. "Please bring me a towel. Hurry, do as you're told. I hate all this water, and I think I have caught a bit of a chill or a cold." To the man who sold fish, I said that my goldfish was going mad in its bowl. It says it hates water and thinks that I ought to go and fetch it a towel. I suppose if you wish to pamper goldfish, you ought to do as you're told. But I honestly wish I'd not sold you that fish, and I'd rather not sell fish worth double their weight in pure gold. Smart Aleck. Smart Aleck, a crook, armed with a hook, robbed river banks. No matter how wide they spread their nets, the police only ever caught a bit of water. Geography lesson. Our teacher told us one day he would leave and sail across a warm blue sea to places he had only known from maps, and all his life had longed to be. The house he lived in was narrow and gray, but in his mind's eyes he could see sweet-scented jasmine clinging to the walls, and green leaves burning on an orange tree. He spoke of the lands he longed to visit, where it was never drab or cold. He couldn't understand why he never left, and shook off the school stranglehold. Then halfway through his final term, he took ill and never returned. He never got to that place on the map where the green leaves of the orange trees burn. The maps were redrawn on the classroom wall. His name forgotten, he faded away. But a lesson he never knew, he taught, is with me to this day. I travel to where the green leaves burn, to where the ocean's glass clear and blue, to places our teacher taught me to love, and which he never knew. Three frazzles in a primpole. One snunk in a snunkle. Two gripes in a grimp, three frazzle in a frimpole, four blips in a blimp, five nips in a nimpole, six nerves in a nip, seven gloops in a gloopole, eight flurps in a flip, nine snuzzles in a snuzzle, 10 lips in a bunny. Some sums are ridiculous, and some sums are funny. The mysterious Smirkel. Some say the Smirkel was a smatterbug and loved to smatterbug about, but exactly what it was or did, we never did find out. Was the Smirkel friendly? Was it calm, meek, and mild? Or was it mean and nasty, belligerent and wild? Did it live on cabbages, or did it live on Mars? Was it made of chocolate drops, or formed by the light of stars? It's one of life's small mysteries, and gladly goes to show there are still things left on the earth that we will never know. In the Jungle Restaurant. In among the green leaves, among the dangling vines, all the hungry creatures were sitting down to dine. "Lucy's juicy," said the tiger. "Hugey chewy," said the lion. "Billy's chilly," said the panther. "Won't you have a bit of mine?" "Peter's pickled," said the rhino. Mary's Harry, said the shark. And this dandy, said the vulture. I found him in the park. Fred is ready, said the python. Daphne's dainty, said the fox. Rita's sweeter, said the cheetah. I stole her off the ox. Chloe's doughy, said the raven. Sally's salty, said the bear. Sammy's tasteless, said the hippo. But I really don't care. Ron Bert the wild pig, except for the very ends. But I'm still a little hungry. Had he any friends?